Kelly Jones. Kelly Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Kelly, it's nice that I met you once very briefly before.
Yeah, you didn't know who I was.
Well, it was an Amnesty International gig, and you were performing on stage with Tom Jones.
Yeah.
Because you recorded with the one, the fabulous album Reloaded. And I was chatting to Tom Jones, who I've met many times, and I said, what are you doing here tonight? He said, I'm singing there with Kelly. And he pointed at you, and I thought you were the bloke there to get his coffee, because you were so unassuming, very shy and quiet in the background, you seem to be.
I know. No, he's a good man, Tom. We've been on a piss with him many times.
He must be, I mean, am I right in thinking you're Welsh as well?
I am Welsh, yeah.
Right, okay. Just thought I'd check. But it seems to me there's loads of great music coming out of Wales at the moment.
Yeah,
because there's you and your band, and then there's, of course, the Manic Street Preachers. They're Welsh, I believe.
Yeah.
Super Furry Animals, they're Welsh.
Yeah.
And Catatonia, I know they're not together so much anymore.
But they are Welsh.
Yeah, so it's kind of like a Welsh renaissance.
Yeah. Well, we all moved to London, so we're all about as Welsh as a doner kebab, aren't we?
The traditional food of the Londoner. Is it? But what I'm right in thinking that, you know, if you're in rock and you're from Oz, you kind of are in the shadow of Tom Jones always. I mean, is that...
Yeah, when you're a kid, it's always Tom Jones or Shirley Bassey, Richard Burton, Anthony Hopkins, that type of thing.
Yeah.
But now I think the kids have got a bit more to talk about. They've got us to talk about now, hopefully. So, yeah, it's been good.
And the new single you're going to sing for us now, which is... It was a Chris Farlow song, I know, but Rod Stewart had a hit with it, didn't he?
Yeah, Rod Stewart did it. It was written by a guy called Mike Darbo, who was in Man From Man.
I thought it was written by Chris Farlow.
No, Chris Farlow did the first... I think he did the first version of it, but Mike Darbo wrote it.
Let me do Stewart that question again. Version. I know you're doing a song which was written by Mark Darbo, and... although many believe Chris Farlow was responsible.
Apparently, yeah.
As it turns out, that is merely a popular misconception.
It's because you're so up on your...
I'm very up on the rock.
..knowledge, yeah.
But you're gonna sing it for us now, I hope.
I'd love to.
That'll be fantastic. Join me next week when my guests will be Ronan Keating, David Blaine and Ronnie Wood. Kelly, if you'd like to go and take the position. Thank you very much indeed. Kelly Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching. Good night.
See a blind man cross the road, trying to make the other side. Ever see a young girl growing old, trying to make herself a bride? So what becomes of you, my love, when they finally strips you off the handbags and the gladrags that your poor old granddad had to sweat to buy you? Once I was a young man, and all I thought I had to do was smile. Well, you are still a young girl, and you bought everything in style. So once you think you're in, you're out, 'cause you don't mean a single thing without the handbags and the gladrags that your poor old granddad had to sweat to buy you. Song sixpence for your sake, and drink a bottle full of rye. Four and 20 blackbirds. muffins and a cake, and bake them all in a pie. They told me you missed school today, so what I suggest you just sell them all away. The handbags and the Gladrags that your poor old granddad had to sweat to buy.
Thank you.